Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video will be a tutorial on how to create this summer sunset eye makeup look. I will let you guys know what I've used on the rest of my face, but the focus will be mostly on my eyes and my lips. I hope you guys enjoy watching this, and if you want to see how I created this look, please keep on watching. This video focuses on my eye makeup look, so I've already done my base for the face, so we can get right into it. I'm just gonna mention the products I've used on my face. To start off, I've used the Maybelline Baby Skin Poreless Primer, the Instant Pore Eraser Primer. Then for foundation, I've used the Chanel La Beige Foundation. I've set everything with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. For concealer, I've used the NYX HD Photogenic Concealer, which is one of my favorite concealers of all time. And then for my face, because this is going to be a summery look, I've bronzed it up quite a bit, so more than I usually do. And I've used, of course, the Butter Bronzer from Physicians Formula with a nice curly peachy shade blush from Maybelline. This one is in the shade Peach Pop. And then as a highlight, I've gone for this really rosy highlight. It's a duochromatic highlight from NYX. It's the shade Snow Rose, and this is absolutely gorgeous. I hope the camera catches it really well because I love this highlight. And then my brows, I have used the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brows in the shade Soft Brown, and I've also used the Clear Brow Gel to lock them into place on a hot summery day. So that is where we are right now, and now we are going into the eye makeup. This is going to be a very summery orange toned eye makeup look, which reminds me a lot of a sunset. And I am going to use the Natural Love palette from Too Faced because it has some really gorgeous summery shades in it. I want to use the lowest row, mostly focusing on this row, with a little hint of the Hunted color. But to start off, I'm going to prime my eyes with the Urban Decay Eye Primer Potion in the original shade. And I'm going to buff that in with my finger. Now to set the eye primer, because I don't want it to crease, I'm going to use a bigger fluffy brush and the first shade of the palette, which is called Heaven, which is just a light, it's not white, it's more of a beige kind of shade, to set my eyelids. And now we can start adding some color. I'm going to start off with the lightest color of the bottom row, which is called Spotlight, and I'm gonna put this into my crease and blending it upwards to my brow. This is gonna be the transition shade of this makeup look. Now next, to deepen up the crease, I'm going to take the next shade to it, which is a more orangey shade, and this is the shade Honey Butter. Same brush, but applying it mostly into the crease. Start off by putting it on the outer corner of your eye and then blending it inwards. You know, windscreen wiper motions. Adding a little bit more to the outside and blending this in. Now we're gonna start with the darkest shade we're going to use, and this one is the shade Odd and Bothered. It has a little bit of sparkle in it, but not too much. And I'm taking a smaller blending brush just on the tip of it, a little bit at a time, to darken up the outer corner of the eyes and to the crease. So we've put down the color, we're going back in, just wiping off my regular blender brush, and we're going back in with the first shade to blend everything out, so that the transition between the colors is really smooth and you don't see a harsh line. This look is all about adding a little bit of color at a time, blending it out. So I'm going back in the hot and buttered color. Taking my other brush and blending this out. Now I am happy with the amount of color I have now, so if you want to make it darker, you can add a little bit more of the hot and buttered color, or you can even go in with the makeup and chill to really deepen it out, but I am happy with this kind of look for an everyday summer look. Now they both look the same to me, so now I'm going in with the fun part, adding a little bit of glitter on it, a little bit of shine, and I'm going to use a flat brush and add some MAC Fix Plus. This one is a little travel size bottle. Spritz a little bit. You can use any kind of setting spray you have to do this. So now I'm going in with the shade Honeypot, which is a gorgeous golden shade which has a little bit of an orange undertone. And I'm putting this on the inner half, inner third of my eye. So now we have the ColourPop on our eyes. I think that little bit of glitter just makes the eyes pop so much more. And then to make everything look seamlessly, we're going back in with the Honey Butter shade, just a little bit, and go over our crease area just slightly. Like so. Voila. Now for under the eyes, I'm going to take my little blender brush, the smaller blender brush, taking hot and buttered again, just focusing it on the outer half of my eye. Like so. And then we are going to take the Honeypot shade with a flat brush, trying to get something on top of it, and do the inner part of our eye. And I'm gonna take that first shade we've used to set our eyeshadow primer on my brush, and taking this under the brow to highlight, like so. And then on the inner corners of our eyes, I'm gonna use that same highlight I've used on my cheeks, so the NYX Duochromatic Illuminating Powder in the shade, what did I say, Snow Rose. I'm putting this on my pinky finger and into the inner corner of my eye. I hope you can see the difference on the camera. So that's it for the eyeshadow. Now for mascara, I'm going to use a waterproof mascara for the summer, because I prefer a waterproof mascara in the summer. And I'm going to use the Hypnose waterproof mascara from Lancôme. It's one of my favorite mascaras of all time. I'm going to coat my upper lashes and my lower lashes. So, eye makeup is done. All we have to do left is our lips. Because I want the focus to be on my eyes, I'm going to take a neutral lip shade, and this one is a liquid lipstick from Max Factor X from the Lipfinity range, and this one is in the shade 006, and this one is just a gorgeous neutral rosy peachy lip color but I think will look perfect with this eye makeup. This lipstick comes in a duo packet. You have the liquid lipstick with the color, of course, and the formula of the liquid lipstick, and then you have this little lip gloss, lip balm thing, which you can put on top of it. You just have to let the color dry for 60 seconds or a little bit longer, and then you can apply the lip balm, and you can reapply the lip balm during the day. I find that these liquid lipsticks last a really long time on the lips. Even when you eat or drink, they just stay there, and with just applying every now and then a little bit of the balm, your lips look as new as ever. So I have a lot of shades of this range. I love them so much. Definitely worth a shot. So now I feel my lips are getting dry, so I'm gonna put on the lip balm. As you can see, this one adds a little bit of gloss on top of the lips, but it's not overly glossy, and you are still comfortable with your own lips. They are so much more fresh on your lips. You don't feel so dry. They don't feel dry on your lips if you put on the balm. So this is it. Thank you guys for watching. If you want to see me do another tutorial with the Natural Love palette from Too Faced, please let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know what kind of look you want to see me do. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you don't want to miss out on any more videos of me, please hit that subscribe button. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter. I will link down everything below. Also, I will link down below all the products I've used on my face. So I will see you next week. Bye.